Hi guys, I'm Alex, and in this quick video I will show you how to upgrade this brand new Acer Extensa 215 5.1 series from 2020 with more RAM, a second hard disk, or are you watching this video in 5 years? Maybe you want to clean the fan or replace the battery, and now I show you how to do that. So, shut down the laptop and remove the DC check and also remove 10 screws at the bottom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I'm already removed 9 screws, so now I'm removing the last screw here. Voila! Here. And now be very, very careful. Use a plastic card or this clip to open this case. I'm already opened this case one time before, so it's a little bit more easier. So you can use this plastic card and be very, very careful. So you can see it. Now the case is open. So a quick show, you can see here is the main board, the CPU. In this video I use a Acer Extensa with a i5 CPU, is fixed on the motherboard. You can't change this CPU. Here you can see one slot, only one slot for the RAM. In this model we have a 8 GB RAM and my customer wants a 16 GB RAM. So we use this standard RAM, 2666 MHz, 8 GB DDR4 RAM. And now if you want to replace them, you can open here this clips. 1, 2, oh yeah, be careful. And insert the 16 GB. So from the side, see it here. I'll show you. You can see it. Clip. Another time. Clip. So if you want to replace the battery, you have to remove this both screws, 1 and 2. One and two. And plug off the cable here. And now this is the battery. In this model we use the type AP16M5J battery. Maybe you have in your Extensa another battery. So here you can see this is the touchpad. You can remove these two screws. Unplug this cable. This is for the touchscreen, for the touchpad. And now you can replace the complete touchpad. Here, this is the connector for the keyboard. But you can see the keyboard is under there. It's fixed on the top cover. So if you want to replace the keyboard, better you buy a complete top cover. And you have to switch all the parts to the new top cover. So here you can see this is a standard battery. You can remove this cable here. And you can insert a standard battery. And here you can find the solid state disk. In this model we use a 512 GB M.2 NVMe Express Solid State Disk. You can use a 1 or 2 terabyte and replace that. Or in this model, we have a 2.5 inch slot for a second hard disk or solid state disk. You can remove this frame here, 1 and 2 screws, and this 2 screws, and you can set in a new second hard disk and plug it here, remove this, and you can connect it with this SATA connector here, and you have now then you have a second hard disk. If you want to replace the fan, remove these 2 screws and remove this stripe here. So, and now you can remove this cable here. Be very, very careful. So, and now we moving the fan. The type, oh, a little bit difficult. That is the type for this model. Maybe they use different fans, I don't know. But what's the problem now? I'm removing this this cable for the Wi-Fi. And we have to plug it again. So now it's plugged again. So back with the CPU fan. Plug in the cable again. If you want to clean the fan, also clean the fan and this part here. It's very important. Many dust after a few years is it in. You can clean it with air pressure or something. So the second screw here. Zoom out. So, back with the battery. Check everything. So, 1, 2. Both screws for the battery pack. And also important, here is the DC check. Now you can see, you can replace the DC check with the cable if the DC check is broken. Buy a new one at eBay or something, and you can change the DC check. That's very, very good. So I think that is all. You can also remove the speakers here and the cable here, and the second speaker is here, the cable plugged in. You can also replace this USB port, the complete part. Yeah, I think that's enough. So now and back the bottom cover, check if everything is connected. Okay. All screws inside. The wireless antenna is plugged in. It's very, very important. All cables are plugged in. 16 gigabytes of RAM is included. So perfect. So, clip, clip, back all the screws, but now we check. We check 16 gigabyte. Plug in the DC check and press F2 for the BIOS. So, have to wait 5, 6, 7, 8 seconds. Press F2. No, maybe it takes 10 seconds because we changed the RAM. So, and now you can see 16 gigabytes of RAM. So, if you want to change the boot order, you can go to main, F12 boot menu, enabled. Exit, F12. So now you can use a Windows 10 stick. Plug in again, reset, F12. This laptop doesn't have a Windows, this model doesn't have Windows. So we install Windows 10. And that's it. If you have any questions, write in the comments and have a nice day.